Doris Chimuri got married in 2009, and as all newlyweds, her husband and herself expected to conceive immediately and have babies. Sadly, that did not happen. As a result, Chimuri spent 10 years before she could conceive a health complication medics blamed on irregular menstrual cycles and blocked fallopian tubes. Today, Chimuri is a happy mother of a 4-year-old, as she shares her story.
I don't even know what it was, because the doctor looked at all the tests, everything we had done with our great doctor. And then he said, I see everything is fine from what I'm seeing, but can we do the fallopian tube check again? But I told him, but I've done this before. He said, let's do it again. This time when I went back to the imaging center to do that tube check, the results showed that my tubes were blocked. So we asked the doctor what could have caused it. And he said, it could be any number of reasons. You could have had an infection or an injury. And then he also said maybe even the miscarriage you had back then, maybe some of that debris or whatever might have caused the blockage. So he suggested a method they call laparoscopy, which he explained was non-intrusive. They would put a small hole and a camera down through my navel, and they would just go into the fallopian tube and scrape it out.
After Chimuri got to know her fallopian tubes were blocked in January 2019, she embarked on a healthy lifestyle with the aim of losing weight, and before she knew it, in June the same year she had conceived.
So January 2019, I am told the tubes are blocked. I tell doctor I am going to juice, I'm going to do castor oil therapy. He says, okay, let's see about that. June, I think, I conceive. We didn't know that we had conceived. Only that, and now I'm, because of the juicing, my periods had regularized. I wasn't missing months. Everything was okay. I was working out. I was eating well. I was at the fittest I've ever been. My body was strong. I was doing my 5-kilometer walk every morning. Then I would be in the gym in the evenings. I was so fit, I could feel it. But then one morning I felt really queasy and funny and weird, and we just decided to buy, you know, those regular strips. And lo and behold, I was pregnant.
Experts attribute the causes of infertility among women to blocked or damaged fallopian tubes, as Dr. Gonzaga Andabati, a senior consultant gynecologist at Bethany Women and Family Hospital, explains that of every 10 women grappling with infertility issues, they are related to fallopian tubes.
Out of 10 women who have infertility, the problem is related to the fallopian tubes. Fallopian tube problems can range from just narrowing of the fallopian tube, can be kinking of the fallopian tube, or it can be complete blockage of the fallopian tube.
Dr. Joseph Muhumza explains how fallopian tubes play a critical role in conception.
Role in the conception process, one is to pick the egg, and after picking the egg, the tubes have to allow the sperm to come and fertilize that egg. After that fertilization has happened, then the tubes have to transport the fertilized baby to the womb. So those are the three roles that the tubes play. So any disturbance in any of the three will result in a tubal cause of infertility.
Dr. Edward Sally, a senior consultant gynecologist at Women's Hospital International and Fertility Center, Bukoto, explains how fallopian tubes coordinate with the reproduction system for conception to take place.
So most women, the tubes are open, but they are lame because of the infection. Infection causes them not to function. And this is the commonest cause of tubal malfunction, is infection.
Experts explain the common causes of tubal blockage as follows.
Of late, we are seeing that actually recurrent miscarriages, especially these miscarriages which are medically or surgically terminated at will. They are the most other common causes of blocked tubes.
Conditions when they are being treated can lead to damage to the fallopian tube. For example, fibroid surgery, you know, you remove the fibroid, when healing occurs, it pulls the fallopian tube and it gets twisted in the wrong direction, away from the ovary.
The cardinal signs of blocked fallopian tubes are not specific, though still there are indicators. Dr. Muhumza further explains some of the processes used to unblock fallopian tubes.
The test called the HSG, the hysterosalpingogram. What it does is it checks for the tubal blockages. But the other importance of it is, on top of checking the blockages, if the blockage is small, the HSG can go ahead and open that blockage during the process of doing it. Okay? So it's usually done on specific days of the cycle. If you do it on other days, there are very high chances that you get false positives and false negatives. So we normally want to do it either on the 9th day of the cycle, or the 10th or the 11th day of the cycle.
Now, once fallopian tube has a problem, that problem has to be defined clearly, because some of the problems are correctable. For example, if the fallopian tube is kinked or twisted because of scars around it, you can correct those scars and that's it. It will work normally. But for some of them, you have to do a process which will bypass the tube.
In the event that the two options fail to open the tubes to enable a woman conceive naturally, then the remaining option is in vitro fertilization, and the cost varies between 15 million shillings to 20 million shillings, as the fertility expert explains.
Now, with IVF technology, we can get out the egg, we can get the sperm and the meat outside in vitro fertilization. Then after fertilization, we put this embryo into the womb. And that is the process of IVF treatment. Yeah, so it's available. It has proven efficacy. The only limitation is the cost.
Although IVF is a solution for women whose fallopian tubes are blocked, there is need to reduce IVF costs and to have trained medical doctors, as Dr. Edward Saleh, Senior Consultant Gynecologist at Women's Hospital International and Fertility Center, Bukoto, explains.
It's not 100%. You can only maximize it by having very good, well-trained doctors, good equipment, because it's safe. We've seen many clinics, very poor results, women.
Protecting your fallopian tubes starts with ensuring personal hygiene and stretches to regular visits, as highlighted.
It's going to save you from these recurrent infections. Recurrent infections, especially the PIDs. So personal hygiene is very important. Then sexual practices. Multiple sexual partners come with the risk that you're going to have your tubes blocked.
According to doctors, ensuring good health of fallopian tubes requires parents talking to their daughters or young girls about the dangers of sexually transmitted diseases, as well as observing a healthy diet.
I have STDs, but the commonest cause of infections which lead to blockage of the tube is infections related to abortions, actually. People remove pregnancies and then they get infections going into the tube. As you know, preventing unwanted pregnancy will be the issue here.
Story compiled by Agnes Chotarengerire for the news.